الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. This is the third lesson of the book that we were going through, خلاصة تعظيم العلم. So we were up to the ninth point. المعقد التاسع. The ninth point that was tied for glorifying knowledge. So we mentioned that the author mentions 20 points in which the person has to come with to actualize glorification of knowledge. So this is point number 9. الصبر في العلم تحملا وأداء. الصبر في العلم, to be patient in knowledge, تحملا وأداء, in two situations, when you're acquiring knowledge and when you're giving out knowledge. So in both cases, when you first are seeking knowledge, gaining knowledge, this needs patience from you. And then when you're spreading that knowledge, teaching, giving back, this also needs patience. إِذْ كُلُّ جَلِيلٍ مِّنَ الْأُمُورِ لَا يُدْرَكُ إِلَّا بِالصَّبْرِ. As everything that is great, every matter that is great, لَا يُدْرَكُ, cannot be attained, cannot be reached, إِلَّا بِالصَّبْرِ, except through صَبْر, patience. وأعظم شيء تتحمل به النفس طلب المعالي. And the greatest thing that the nafs, the greatest thing that the nafs is able to persevere, or the greatest thing that the nafs can withhold and try to acquire, is تصبيرها عليه. When, يعني the greatest thing that the nafs can persevere, or that it can attain, when it wants to reach that which is high, is تصبيرها عليه, is يعني perseverance and patience upon that which it is seeking. ولهذا, and because of this, كان الصبر صبر was والمصابرة. And also this is also patience, يعني patience and perseverance were مأمورا بهما, were commanded, لتحصيل أصل الإيمان تارة, to attain the foundation of إيمان once, ولتحصيل كماله تارة أخرى, and to attain the completeness of إيمان another time. So we were commanded to come with صبر in both cases. يعني we are commanded to be patient upon يعني acquiring the foundation of إيمان, أصل الإيمان, يعني إيمان itself. And then also we are told to be patient in completing that إيمان, in completing that إيمان. So in both cases, foundation of the iman, you need sabr. When you want to attain the foundation of the iman, that which you cannot be a Muslim without. And then that which is from kamalul iman, يعني the completeness of iman, that also needs sabr. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اصْبِرُوا وَصَابِرُوا. Oh you who believe, اصْبِرُوا, be patient, وَصَابِرُوا. And يعني be more patient than the enemy, يعني the kuffar. وقال تعالى, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَاصْبِرْ نَفْسَكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ يَدْعُونَ رَبَّهُمْ بِالْغَدَاةِ وَالْعَشِيِّ يُرِيدُونَ وَجْهَهُ. And keep yourself patient by being with those who remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the morning and also in the evening. يُرِيدُونَ وَجْهَهُ. They are worshipping him. Why? Because they want his pleasure. They want his rahmah. They want his face. قال يحيى بن أبي كثير. يحيى بن أبي كثير, he said, في تفسير هذه الآية, in the tafsir of this ayah, هي مجالس الفقه. And when he was talking about this ayah, Yahya ibn Abi Kathir, he said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is referring to the circles of knowledge. وَلَنْ يُحَصِّلَ أَحَدٌ الْعِلْمَ إِلَّا بِالصَّبْرِ. And no one will acquire knowledge except through patience. قَالَ يَحْيَ بْنُ أَبِي كَثِيرٍ أَيْضًا. Yahya ibn Abi Kathir also said, لَا يُسْتَطَاعُ الْعِلْمُ بِرَاحَةِ الْجِسْمِ. يعني knowledge cannot be attained with the comfort of the body. So my dear brothers and sisters, he's emphasizing in this ma'qid the importance of patience for a student of knowledge. Anyone who wants and something which is great, whether it relates to the dunya or the akhirah, the person will always need sabr to reach that which they are seeking. And knowledge is from those things where you need sabr. It needs sabr from you to attain it. Attending the class needs sabr. Paying attention to the dars needs sabr. Memorizing that which you need to memorize, it needs sabr. Revising needs sabr. Acting upon that which you have learnt, it needs sabr. Renewing your intention time after time, it needs sabr. Yani knowledge cannot be attained without sabr. And Yahya ibn Abi Kathir, he mentioned this athar, لا يستطاع العلم براحة الجسم, that knowledge cannot be attained with the comfort of the body. Someone who wants to relax all the time cannot attain knowledge. Someone who wants to sleep 8 to 10 hours a day, يعني cannot attain knowledge. And knowledge, it needs sacrifice. It needs time. And it needs a lot of time. A lot of the time what happens is when the people are sleeping, you are going to have to be seeking knowledge. When the people are celebrating or having fun, you're going to have to be seeking knowledge. So when someone wants to reach a very high place in knowledge, someone wants to become a scholar, someone wants to understand the Quran and the Sunnah, wants to attain the sciences, different sciences, then they are going to have to be patient. And Imam Muslim, رحمه الله تعالى, he mentioned this athar of Yahya ibn Abi Kathir in his book, in his Sahih, in the middle of Kitab al-Salah. In the middle of Kitab al-Salah. يعني he was bringing the ahadith that pertain to Salah. And then he brought this athar. So the scholars, they tried to figure out why. Why did Al-Imam Muslim bring this athar in Kitab al-Salah? Because this has nothing to do with Salah. This is talking about patience and being patient upon seeking knowledge. And they found that Imam Muslim, the ahadith that he mentioned before this athar, it needed a lot of work And those ahadith had a lot of turuq. They had a lot of different chains of narrations. And يعني, it did not come easy to attain these narrations. And then to, you know, to bring out that which is sahih, that which is authentic. And then to bring them in his book. It wasn't just merely writing them. There was a lot of hard work that was done before he brought those ahadith. So when he realized the difficulty that something like this needs, then he put this athar there. And he said, لا يستطاع العلم براحة الجسم. That knowledge cannot be attained through the comfort of the body. فبالصبر يخرج من معرة الجهل. With sabr, one can go out of the lowliness of ignorance. وبه تدرك لذة العلم. And by sabr, the person will reach the sweetness of knowledge. So when we start seeking knowledge, it is difficult, it is heavy on the nafs. Maybe when you start seeking knowledge, you won't be able to sit down for many hours. Maybe all you can do is 30 minutes a day, or at the very most, maybe an hour a day. But if the person continues and is patient and sticks with seeking knowledge, and always, even if the person cuts off, something comes in between them and knowledge, and they become busy, they stop for a while, they become lazy, you know. And if they always come back, then bi-idhnillahi ta'ala, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sees the sidq of the person, the truthfulness of the person, and their sincerity, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will open doors for them. So you will see that person that wasn't able to sit down for 15 minutes or 30 minutes, you will see them, you know, they cannot wait until they get to their books. They cannot wait until they go and listen to the dars. They cannot wait until they go sit down and memorize. And you'll find them always prioritizing knowledge and giving it precedence over everything, يعني. Whether it is gatherings, family gatherings, or hanging out with friends, or traveling, يعني you'll find them always giving precedence to seeking knowledge. So this, by you being patient at the beginning, going through those tough times and being patient, coming with perseverance, making dua that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala opens doors for you, this will lead you inshallah ta'ala to acquiring the sweetness of seeking knowledge. So وَبِهِ and with sabr, وَبِالصَّبْرِ تُدْرَكُ لَذَّةُ الْعِلْمِ. And the sweetness of ilm will be reached with sabr. وَصَبْرُ الْعِلْمِ نَوْعَان. And being patient upon ilm is of two types. From the examples of patience is Abdullah ibn Abbas رضي الله عنه, the Sahabi Abdullah ibn Abbas رضي الله عنه, when he was seeking knowledge from the older Sahaba. So when the Prophet passed away, Abdullah ibn Abbas was still young. So after the Prophet passed away, he was seeking knowledge from the Sahaba. So he would go to the Sahabi's house and he would wait in front of the house. He would go sit in front of the house and wait for the Sahabi to come out. And sometimes he would lie down. And then the Sahabi would come out and see, for example, Sahabi would come out for the Salah. And he would see Abdullah ibn Abbas lying down on the floor, and the wind has blown dust onto his clothes and onto his face. And the Sahabi would be shocked. And they would say, Ya ibn Ammi Rasulillah, O cousin of the Prophet alayhi salatu wassalam. And what are you doing here? Why didn't you, you know, come inside and let us know that you're here? They want to honor Abdullah ibn Abbas. He's the cousin of the Prophet alayhi salam. And even if they could, if Abdullah ibn Abbas could get the Sahaba to come to him, they would happily go to him and give him that knowledge. But Abdullah ibn Abbas, he chose being patient and persevering when it comes to seeking knowledge. Some of the scholars, they say that he was acting upon the ayah, وَلَوْ أَنَّهُمْ صَبَرُوا حَتَّى تَخْرُجَ إِلَيْهِمْ لَكَانَ خَيْرًا لَهُمْ. If they were patient enough, just to the point where you would come out to them, that would have been better for them. And if they would have just waited outside until you came out, that would have been better for them. So he says, وَصَبْرُ الْعِلْمِ نَوْعَانِ. The patience of knowledge is of two types. يعني being patient upon knowledge is of two types. أحدهما, the first of them is صبر في تحمله وأخذه. Being patient in attaining knowledge and taking knowledge. فالحفظ يحتاج إلى صبر. Memorization needs صبر. والفهم يحتاج إلى صبر. Understanding the درس needs صبر. You know, even understanding the درس, it needs you to repeat that dars many times. When you repeat a particular lesson or a book that you have studied, when you read it the first time, and then you read it the second time and the third time, there is a very big difference. When you read it the second time and the third time, you understand more masail. And then the fourth time, you understand even more. And this is why the scholars, they would repeat one book so many times to the point that book became yani like the Fatiha for them. Al-Imam An-Nawawi once, and he was, a man argued with him over a mas'ala, and the man tried to argue that, you know, it is in the book of so and so. He mentioned the book, I think he mentioned the book of Al-Ghazali, Al-Wasit, a book of Al-Wasit, and that's in fiqh, and authored by Imam Al-Ghazali. So he said, that man said to Imam Al-Nawawi, you know, this is mentioned in the book Al-Wasit by Imam Al-Ghazali. And Imam Al-Nawawi said, yani, I read the book of Imam Al-Ghazali 600 times. I read it 600 times. So this shows you that they repeated these books many times. They studied these books many, many times. So that book was probably an important book, a very important book at the time. Maybe it was the main book when it came to seeking the knowledge of fiqh. So there are books that are very important, that are, you know, an imperative for a student's foundation of knowledge. These kind of books, the student repeats it many times, so that they are able to, you know, memorize that which is in it, understand it very well. So understanding also needs sabr. وحضور مجالس العلم يحتاج إلى صبر. And attending the circles of knowledge also needs sabr. ورعاية حق الشيخ تحتاج إلى صبر. And also being mindful of the rights of the sheikh also needs sabr. So a lot of the time, the sheikh can be very harsh. Sheikh can be very harsh when it comes to how the Sheikh deals with his students. So if the Sheikh, you know, is a bit harsh on you, says harsh words, and then khalas, you decide, you know what, khalas, I'm not going to attend this Sheikh's dars anymore. This Sheikh, you know, doesn't have manners. And you deprive yourself of the knowledge that Shaykh, you know, would have given you. So if you're patient upon the harshness of your Shaykh, if you're patient upon, you know, respecting the Shaykh, it needs sabr to respect the Shaykh. And this will also and allow you to attain the knowledge that the Shaykh has. And those who are perseverant when it comes to the way the Shaykh deals with them, a lot of the times you find them, they become very close with the Shaykh. And the Shaykh starts to treat them like a son. And he gives them knowledge. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala opens the heart of the shaykh for that student that was patient. والنوع الثاني, and the second type of knowledge when it comes to knowledge is صبر في أدائه وبثه, to be patient in giving out knowledge and spreading knowledge, وتبليغه إلى أهله, and to relay it to the people, to its people, يعني the people that are seeking knowledge. فالجلوس للمتعلمين يحتاج إلى صبر, to sit down for those who want to learn and to teach them needs صبر. وإفهامهم يحتاج إلى صبر, and to, you know, make them understand also needs صبر, it needs patience. They mentioned that Imam al-Shafi'i رحمه الله تعالى, he repeated a mas'ala for one of his close students. He repeated the mas'ala for him, يعني he didn't understand in the majlis, in the sitting. And in the sitting, Imam al-Shafi'i repeated the mas'ala for him 40 times. And he realized that he still did not understand. So he took him after the dars, he took him somewhere, he sat down with him and he started to explain to him even more until he understood. Look at the patience the Shaykh or Imam al-Shafi'i has when it comes to, you know, giving importance to the students and getting him to understand, assisting him in understanding the mas'ala. And then also another benefit we can take from this is, yani those people that came before us, that were, you know, the Salaf, yani they were just like us. You know, they were not born with knowledge. They had to seek it. And a lot of the times they were not able to understand some masail, but they were patient and they repeated. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala opened doors for them. So when you do not understand a book, when you do not understand a mas'ala, this should not, you know, take you away from knowledge. Rather, this should make you want to be more patient and to look at the mas'ala again and again and again until بإذن الله تعالى Allah opens it for you. واحتمال زلاتهم يحتاج إلى صبر, and bearing their mistakes يحتاج needs صبر, يعني bearing the mistakes of the students also needs patience. وفوق هذين النوعين من صبر العلم, and on top of these two types that we mentioned, يعني these two types of صبر when it comes to knowledge, on top of these two types is الصبر على الصبر فيهما, to be patient upon being patient on those two things. So the patience of acquiring knowledge and the patience of, you know, spreading knowledge needs patience. يعني it needs perseverance. You need to be steadfast on that path. So you had the patience to sit down today and to memorize. But for you to continue every single day and to be consistent, this needs patience. So the patience that you need for that particular dars is different from the patience that you need to be consistent and to be firm upon seeking knowledge. So you have to remind yourself that continuing and persevering and being consistent also needs patience. الصبر على الصبر فيهما والثبات عليهما, to be patient upon the two types of patience that were mentioned, والثبات عليهما, and to be steadfast upon them. The scholars, they say الصبر في الجهاد صبر ساعة والصبر في العلم صبر عمر, and to be patient upon jihad. When someone needs to be patient upon jihad, and he needs that patience for a small amount of time. When that war finishes, then خلاص. But when patience for knowledge it needs the whole, يعني the lifespan of a person, because a person is always going to be seeking knowledge until they pass away. لكل إلى شأو العلا وثبات ولكن عزيز في الرجال ثبات. In this bait he mentions that everyone has jumps to high goals. يعني everyone attempts to reach high goals. ولكن عزيز في الرجال ثبات. But it is very rare amongst the men to be steadfast. It is something which is very, very rare. So in this ma'qid, my dear brothers and sisters, the Shaykh mentioned the importance of being patient. And every khayr and that someone wants to attain in this dunya or the akhirah, it needs patience. So we should train ourselves. One day a man came to Imam Ibn Baz, rahimahullah ta'ala, and he was complaining. The man, he was a da'i, he was someone who would give da'wah a lot, and he was complaining to Imam Ibn Baz. He was complaining about the people, you know, not accepting, and that he does not find the fruits of his da'wah. And Imam Ibn Baz, he mentioned to him, he took his fingers and he read the ayah, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا صَبِرُوا, يعني be patient, وَصَابِرُوا يعني beat others, يعني your enemy, beat them in patience, وَرَابِطُوا, and persevere, وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ, and fear Allah. When you come with these four, what will happen? لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ, then you will be successful. So the people that are spreading batil, the people that are spreading corruption on the earth, you know, they have so much patience, they have so much drive, they have so much perseverance when it comes to spreading that which is corrupt. They use all the avenues that they can use to lie to the people, to يعني, spread misinformation, to oppress. And they use everything that they can, they have the ability to use. And then those who want to attain, you know, that which is less when it comes to knowledge or compared to knowledge. And for example, dunya, someone when they want to attain dunya, someone wants to become, for example, wealthy, they persevere and they're patient. Why can't we be patient upon seeking knowledge? We have to give more than what the people and of corruption and the patience that those people and the effort that those people are coming with, at least we have to come the same and kind of effort to push it away. المعقد العاشر, the 10th point that was tied for glorifying knowledge is ملازمة آداب العلم. It is to remain with the adab of ilm, the manners of ilm and its etiquettes. قال ابن القيم رحمه الله تعالى في كتابه مدارج السالكين. ابن القيم رحمه الله تعالى said in his book مدارج السالكين, أدب المرء عنوان سعادته وفلاحه. The manners of a person, when someone has good manners, عنوان سعادته وفلاحه, is the sign of their happiness and their success. ابن القيم رحمه الله تعالى in his book مدارج السالكين, he mentions أدب المرء عنوان سعادته وفلاحه. And good manners of a person is a sign to his happiness and his success. وَقِلَّةُ أَدَبِهِ, and the rarity of his manners is عِنْوَانُ شَقَاوَتِهِ وَبَوَارِهِ, It is a sign of his wretchedness and his destruction. فَمَسْتُجْلِبَ خَيْرُ الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ بِمِثْلِ الْأَدَبِ. And the khayr of the dunya and the akhirah is not attracted and lured by something like adab. And it is not, the khayr of the dunya and akhirah cannot be attained through something like good manners. وَلَسْتُجْلِبَ حِرْمَانُهُمَا بِمِثْلِ قِلَّةِ الْأَدَبِ. And the lack of the khayr of the dunya and the akhirah, and he's not attracted and with something like qillatul adab, the rarity of al adab, good manners. So good manners bring you khayr of the dunya and the akhirah. And if the person lacks good manners, this deprives them of the khayr of the dunya and the akhirah. والمرء لا يسمو بغير الأدب وإن يكن ذا حسب ونسب. And the person is not elevated without knowledge, without manners. The person is not elevated without manners. وإن يكن ذا حسب ونسب. Even if the person is someone who has an honorable ancestry or someone has very good lineage. And when the person does not have good manners, and his good lineage or his wealth, and these things will not help the person when the person does not have good manners. When someone has bad manners, and people try to avoid him, try to get away from that person, even if that person, you know, has other things. وَإِنَّمَا يَصْلُحُ لِلْعِلْمِ مَنْ تَأَدَّبَ بِآدَابِهِ فِي نَفْسِهِ وَدَرْسِهِ وَمَعَ شَيْخِهِ وَقَرِينِهِ. And knowledge is suitable only for the one who adorns themselves with its adab, with the adab of knowledge. فِي نَفْسِهِ, in his nafs. وَدَرْسِهِ, and in his lesson. وَمَعَ شَيْخِهِ, and with his shaykh. وَقَرِينِهِ, and his fellow students. قَالَ يُوسُفُ بْنُ الْحُسَيْنِ. Yusuf ibn al-Husayn, he said, bil adabi tafhamu al-ilm. You will understand knowledge with adab. لِأَنَّ الْمُتَأَدِّبَ يُرَى أَهْلًا لِلْعِلْمِ فَيُبْذَلُ لَهُ. Why? Because the one who has good manners is seen to be suitable for knowledge. And then he's given that knowledge. وَقَلِيلُ الْأَدَبِ يُعَزُّ الْعِلْمُ أَنْ يُضَيَّعَ عِنْدَهُ. And the one who has very little adab, very little manners, knowledge is more honorable than being wasted on that person. So the statement of Yusuf ibn al-Husayn, bil adabi tafhamu al-ilm, you will understand knowledge with adab, can have two meanings. The Shaykh mentioned one of the meanings, which is that when, you know, someone, a Shaykh for example, sees someone that has adab, someone that has manners, yani the shaykh opens up to that person. The shaykh wants to benefit that person as much as they want. But when someone that is qaleel al-adab, someone that, you know, has bad manners comes, then the shaykh does not want to give them knowledge. The shaykh turns them away. The shaykh turns them away. And even sometimes the shaykh, even if he still wants to give that person knowledge, and the shaykh will not find, you know, he won't be opened, his heart won't be open to benefiting that person. So that's one of the meanings, and the shaykh mentioned that. Another meaning can be that, يعني بالأدب تفهم العلم, you understand knowledge with adab, is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blocks the heart of the person. Let's say, for example, the shaykh actually wants to give that person knowledge, and he does not mind that person's bad manners, and he still wants to, inshallah ta'ala, benefit them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because of that person's adab, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blocks that knowledge. And you'll find that person not being able to understand or not being able to be consistent, come back to that dars or memorize. All of that because of the person's manners. ومن هنا كان السلف رحمهم الله يعتنون بتعلم الأدب كما يعتنون بتعلم العلم. And from here, the Salaf رحمهم الله تعالى, they would give importance to learning adab, learning good manners. كما يعتنون بتعلم العلم, like they would give importance to seeking knowledge. So just like one of us, you know, comes and gives importance to seeking knowledge, يعني attaining knowledge, coming to the dars, memorizing, writing, all of these things, we should give importance to also attaining adab. Okay, what do I need and when it comes to manners of seeking knowledge? How do I deal with the sheikh? How do I deal with my classmate? How do I deal with the book? All of these things. A person needs to learn these things just like he is learning to attain knowledge. قال ابن سيرين رحمه الله. Ibn Sirin said, may Allah have mercy on him, كانوا يتعلمون الهدي كما يتعلمون العلم. They were ones who would learn الهدي. يعني they would learn the correct way to conduct oneself, the correct way to seek knowledge, the manners that the person needs to come with. They would learn that just like they would learn knowledge. بل إن طائفة منهم يقدمون تعلمه على تعلم العلم. Rather, a group of them, a group of the Salaf, they would give precedence to learning adab over learning, attaining knowledge. So they would give more importance to attaining the adab, the manners of seeking knowledge. They would give that more importance over يعني attaining knowledge. قال مالك بن أنس لفتى من قريش. مالك بن أنس, الإمام مالك, he said لفتى من قريش, to a boy of the people of قريش, يبن أخي, oh son of my brother, تعلم الأدب قبل أن تتعلم العلم. يعني learn adab, learn the good manners that you need to seek knowledge before you seek knowledge. وكانوا يظهرون حاجتهم إليه. And they would show and their need for it. For what? For manners. قال مخلد بن الحسين لابن المبارك يوما. مخلد بن الحسين, he said to ابن المبارك one of the days, نحن إلى كثير من الأدب أحوج منا إلى كثير من العلم. مخلد بن الحسين, he said to ابن المبارك, عبد الله بن المبارك, he said to him, we are in more need of good manners than the need that we have for knowledge. يعني our need for good manners is more than our need for beneficial knowledge. وكانوا يوصون به ويرشدون إليه. And they would advise, you know, others to attain good manners. ويرشدون إليه. And they would direct them towards it. قال مالك, الإمام مالك said, كانت أمي تعممني. My mom was someone who would put the imama on my head. And she would prepare me for going out and seeking knowledge. وتقول لي, and she would say to me, اذهب إلى ربيعة. Go to ربيعة. تعني ابن أبي عبد الرحمن. She was speaking about, or she meant ابن أبي عبد الرحمن, ربيعة الرأي. فقيه أهل المدينة في زمنه. The فقيه of the people of Medina in his time. So she would tell me, go to ربيعة الرأي. فتعلم من أدبه قبل علمه. And learn from his adab, from his manners, and the way he conducts himself before his knowledge. وإنما حرم كثير من طلبة العصر العلم بتضييع الأدب. And a lot of the students of knowledge of this time are deprived of knowledge because of the forsaking of the manners of knowledge. أشرف الليث ابن سعد رحمه الله على أصحاب الحديث. يعني الليث ابن سعد, he looked at students that were the people of hadith. يعني students that were attaining أحاديث. فرأى منهم شيئا كأنه كرهه, and he saw from them something that he disliked. So he saw students that were attaining the ilm of hadith, يعني they were seeking hadith, and he saw from them in their manners, the way they were carrying themselves, he saw something that he disliked. فقال, so he said, ما هذا, what is this, أنتم إلى يسير من الأدب أحوج منكم إلى كثير من العلم. يعني you lot need a little bit of adab more than a lot of knowledge. You need a little bit of adab, يعني a little bit of adab will benefit you more than يعني a lot of knowledge without adab. فماذا يقول الليث لو رأى حال كثير من طلاب العلم في هذا العصر. So what would Al-Layth ibn Sa'd say if he was to see the situation of a lot of the students of knowledge in this time? So in this ma'qid, my dear brothers and sisters, the Shaykh is showing us the importance of adab when it comes to attaining knowledge, and that the person has to come with good manners to be from those who glorify knowledge. And if the person does not come with the adab of knowledge, the person can deprive themselves of a lot that they could have attained with al-adab. Al-ma'qid al-hadi ashar, the 11th point. Siyanatul ilmi amma yashin mimma yukhalifu al-muru'ata wa yakhrimuha. It is to protect knowledge from that which blemishes it. مِمَّا يُخَالِفُ الْمُرُوءَةِ وَيَخْرِمُهَا. From the things that oppose al-muru'ah, وَيَخْرِمُهَا, and punctures it. يعني al-muru'ah is, he's going to mention it insha'Allah ta'ala, is استعمال ما يجملك ويزينك وتجنب ما يدنسك ويشينك. It is to, يعني, to come with that which beautifies you and adorns you, and to stay away from that which tarnishes you or blemishes you. This is al-muru'ah, يعني coming with everything that will beautify your personality, and to stay away from everything that will blemish it. So the Shaykh said, مَنْ لَمْ يَصُنِ الْعِلْمَ لَمْ يَصُنْهُ الْعِلْمُ. Whoever doesn't protect knowledge will not protect them. يعني the person that does not protect knowledge from that which blemishes it, that which will bring dishonor to it, يعني علم does not protect him. كما قال الشافعي, as الإمام الشافعي said, وَمَنْ أَخَلَّ بِالْمُرُوءَةِ بالوقوع فيما يشين فقد استخف بالعلم. And whoever breaches the muru'ah, we mentioned, what is muru'ah? To come with that which beautifies you and adorns you, يعني from the actions, and to stay away from that which blemishes you. So this is muru'ah. Inshallah ta'ala, we're just going to be mentioning muru'ah. ومن أخل بالمروءه, whoever breaches the muru'ah, بالوقوع فيما يشين, by falling into that which blemishes, فقد استخف بالعلم, then that person has undervalued knowledge. فلم يعظمه, and that person has not glorified knowledge. ووقع في البطالة, and the person falls into idleness. فتفضي به الحال إلى زوال اسم العلم عنه, and this leads that person to, this situation leads him to, يعني the term of knowledge being stripped from that person. or the name of knowledge being stripped from that person. قال وهب بن منبه رحمه الله تعالى وهب بن منبه he said لا يكون البطال من الحكماء يعني the one who is idle and lazy does not become from the from those who are wise. وجماع المروءة and that which gathers مروءة for you. المروءة we're talking about مروءة. He's going to give us a definition that will gather مروءة for us. وجماع المروءة and that which defines or gathers مروءة is كما قاله ابن تيمية الجد is and that which ابن تيمية الجد the grandfather ابن تيمية الجد and said in his محرر يعني the grandfather of ابن تيمية. So there's ابن تيمية الجد and there's ابن تيمية الحفيد. So ابن تيمية and the very common one that we know is the grandson. His grandfather was also a scholar. أبو البركات مجد بن تيمية. أبو البركات مجد بن تيمية. He was the grandfather of أحمد بن عبد الحليم بن عبد السلام ابن تيمية أبو العباس. So the grandfather mentioned this definition for مروءة. And the grandson followed him in this definition. He said in some of his fatawa that مروءة is استعمال ما يجمله ويزينه أو ويزينه. It is for the person to use, to come with that which adorns them and beautifies them. وتجنب ما يدنسه ويشينه. And to stay away from that which tarnishes them and blemishes them. قيل لأبي محمد سفيان بن عيينة it was said to أبو محمد سفيان بن عيينة قد استنبط من القرآن كل شيء you have extrapolated from the Quran everything فأين المروءة فيه so where is مروءة in the Quran يعني where was مروءة mentioned in the Quran فقال so he said في قوله تعالى in the saying of Allah خذ العفو take يعني forgiveness forgive the people those who wrong you وأمر بالعرف and command the good وأعرض عن الجاهلين and turn away from the ignorant ones so he said in this ayah مروءة is mentioned يعني all of these things that you're commanded to come within this ayah it fixes your مروءة ففيه المروءة وحسن الأدب ومكارم الأخلاق. In this ayah is the مروءة وحسن الأدب and good etiquettes ومكارم الأخلاق and lofty mannerisms. So in this معقد, the Shaykh is mentioning that we should come with that which adorns, you know, knowledge. If you are a student of knowledge, you shouldn't be like everyone else. You should be distinguished. يعني with we're not talking about in a way with kibir or arrogance we're talking about that you should be distinguished with everything that beautifies you and by staying away from everything that blemishes you because you're carrying knowledge and when someone is a student of knowledge they are like a white cloth And everyone else, يعني the عامه, they are like a black cloth. So a student of knowledge who is known to seek knowledge, or even a sheikh, when something, a mistake occurs, or they come with something that blemishes knowledge, what happens? It stands out. It's much bigger compared to someone who is يعني just a layman. So therefore, a student of knowledge, those who are seeking knowledge and those who are spreading knowledge, teaching knowledge, they should always protect, you know, knowledge. مَنْ لَمْ يَصُنِ الْعِلْمِ لَمْ يَصُنْهُ الْعِلْمِ And whoever doesn't protect knowledge, then knowledge does not protect them. وَمِنْ أَلْزَمِ أَدَبِ النَّفْسِ لِلطَّالِبِ And from the most important manners of the nafs, that a student should come with is تحليه بالمروءه. It is to be characterized with مروءه, to be distinguished with مروءه. وما يحمل عليها, and that which leads to it. وتنكبه خوارمها التي تخل بها. And for him to stay away from everything that diminishes that and that مروءه التي تخل بها, that يعني makes it deficient, كحلق لحيته, like shaving the beard, أو كثرة الالتفات في الطريق, looking around too much when someone is walking on the road, أو مد الرجلين في مجمع الناس من غير حاجة, and for someone to spread out their legs when they're sitting with a group of people. These things that he mentioned, يعني these things that are من خوارم المروءة, things that make your مروءة deficient, they can be haram, and they can also be things that are not haram. So for example, shaving the beard, we're talking about clean shaving, this is haram. يعني تخل بالمروءة, it punctures the مروءة. Something like spreading out your legs in front of a group of people, this might not be haram, but it still makes your muru'ah less, it makes it deficient. It is not from the things that beautify you, adorn you, it is from the things that blemishes you. So to spread out the legs في مجمع الناس, in a gathering of people, من غير حاجة, without any need, ولا ضرورة داعية إليه, or without any necessity. So of course, if the person has a condition where they have to spread those legs out, maybe because the person has knee problems or back problems or whatever it is, and in this case, of course, an exception is made. But if the person does it without a need, then this is where it might go against the muru'ah. أو صحبة الأراذل والفساق والمجان والبطالين, أو مصارعة الأحداث والصغار. Also from the things that puncture the مروءه is صحبة الأراذل, to accompany those who are low, والفساق, and those who are sinful, والمجان. مجان is جمع ماجن, someone who does everything and anything without thinking about it, someone who does things without يعني thinking about it, someone who is shameless. والبطالين, and those who are idle and lazy. And accompanying these people is from those things that are من خوارم المروءة, those things that make your مروءة deficient. أو مصارعة الأحداث والصغار, wrestling those who are young and small. And imagine you see the sheikh, the big sheikh, in the masjid wrestling with the kids. And it might be from the urf, it might be from the also, you know, the muru'ah, a lot of the time it is dictated by urf, by traditions and the customs of a people. So if something is seen to be يعني something that blemishes, then it will come under that which blemishes the muru'ah. If it's seen to be from those things that do not blemish, then it is not from the things that blemish the muru'ah. So for example, in the Arab countries, some things might go against the muru'ah. Those same things in the West might not go against the muru'ah. So a lot of the time, and that which dictates that which is good for your muru'ah or not good for it is the adat, the customs. Okay? And so we should, of course, there are things that are agreed upon. So for example, the sheikh taking off his shirt and walking outside, or the student of knowledge taking off his shirt, walking outside shirtless, for example. And that's not haram, right? If the person covers their awrah, the person covers the awrah from the from the belly button to the knee. يعني the person has covered the awrah. So if the person takes off the shirt and the awrah is covered, then that person is not falling into haram. But if someone does this, like the student of knowledge, or the imam of the masjid, or the sheikh of the city, if he does that, what will the people say? يعني? They'll say, يعني, the sheikh last night, I think, lost his mind. Huh? Sahih? So, a lot of the time, يعني, things that are mubah, that sometimes are allowed, can fall into that which goes against your muru'ah. And then we mentioned that, and the muru'ah is also, that which goes against the muru'ah can also be dictated by customs. Nah. المعقد الثاني عشر. I think this is the last ma'qid that we will do tonight. The 12th point that was tied for glorifying knowledge. انتخاب الصحبة الصالحة له. It is to choose and to pick الصحبة الصالحة. يعني righteous and companionship. له للعلم for knowledge. اتخاذ الزميل ضرورة لازمة في نفوس الخلق. يعني to take a companion, a friend, is a ضرورة, a necessity, which is a must في نفوس الخلق, in the نفوس of the creation. يعني us and as the creation, يعني we want to mix with people, we want to deal with people, we want to live with people. We do not want to become lonely. And is there anyone that can just go out in the desert and just live by themselves? Maybe there is, but it's very rare. So people always want to be with people and accompany people. So it's from our fitrah, it's from our nature. فَيَحْتَاجُ طَالِبُ الْعِلْمِ إِلَى مُعَاشَرَةِ غَيْرِهِ مِنَ الطُّلَّابِ. So the student of knowledge needs to befriend and mix with غَيْرِهِ مِنَ الطُّلَّابِ, other than him of the students. لِتُعِينَهُ هَذِهِ الْمُعَاشَرَةِ عَلَى تَحْصِيلِ الْعِلْمِ وَالِاجْتِهَادِ فِي طَلَبِهِ. So that this معاشرة, this mixing and accompanying, helps him attain knowledge. وَالِاجْتِهَادِ فِي طَلَبِهِ. And it helps him to work hard in seeking knowledge. وَالزَّمَالَةُ فِي الْعِلْمِ إِنْ سَلِمَتْ مِنَ الْغَوَائِلِ نَافِعَةٌ فِي الْوُصُولِ إِلَى الْمَقْصُودِ. And friendship in knowledge, if it is safe from الغوائل, if it's safe from calamities, يعني for example, if it's safe from kibr, arrogance, if it's safe from oppressing others, if it's safe from al-hasad, you know, being envious of others, if it's safe from all these calamities, then it is nafi'atun, it is beneficial في الوصول إلى المقصود, in reaching the objective. So when someone has a friend, a companion that is righteous, that seeks knowledge with them, then this is very, very, very beneficial. It is very beneficial. يعني, you need a sheikh to teach you. It's very important. But from the things that are also, that come like right after that, when it comes to importance, is friendship in seeking knowledge. To have someone who is hardworking and righteous, and someone who has very high aspirations, someone that motivates you to seek knowledge. So this takes the person a very long way. الصحبة في طلب العلم, to have a companion in your seeking of knowledge. ولا يحسن بقاصد العلا. Maybe inshallah ta'ala these majalis, they will form some blessed friendships that, you know, a lot of us will find, inshallah ta'ala, those who can accompany us in our journey of seeking knowledge. Because seeking knowledge, my dear brothers and sisters, is wadifatul umr. It is the يعني, occupation of the whole lifespan of a person. There is no, you know, a limit that you reach or a destination that you reach where you say, okay, alhamdulillah, I have attained all of knowledge. So a serious student of knowledge will continue to seek knowledge until they pass away, until they meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَا يَحْسُنُ بِقَاصِدِ الْعُلَى إِلَّا انْتِخَابْ صُحْبَةٍ صَالِحَةٍ تُعِينُهُ فَإِنَّ لِلْخَلِيلِ فِي خَلِيلِهِ أَثَرًا. And it does not befit the one who is aiming for that which is high. It does not befit him except to choose صُحْبَةٍ صَالِحَةٍ, righteous companions. تُعِينُهُ, that help that person, that help that person. فَإِنَّ لِلْخَلِيلِ فِي خَلِيلِهِ أَثَرًا. Why? Because verily the close intimate friend has an effect on his close friend. روى أبو داود والترمذي عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه. أبو داود and Tirmidhi narrated from أبو هريرة رضي الله عنه أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال, that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, الرجل على دين خليله. The man is upon the deen of his close friend. فَلْيَنْظُرْ أَحَدُكُمْ مَنْ يُخَالِلْ. So one of you should look at those who he takes as a close friend. Yani those who he takes as close friends. You should look at those who you're taking as a close friend. Why? Because the person is upon the deen of his close friend. A lot of us, you know, we're naive when it comes to our friends. We think that our friends do not affect us. So a lot of us have friends that are bad for us. That when we're with them, we're in trouble. Every time we see them, يعني, there's problems, there's issues. But we tell ourselves that they are like that. This is just my friend. You know, I'm not like that. But أخي and يعني my dear brother and my dear sister, يعني this is a naive way of thinking. You're opening doors of fitna to yourself by thinking like this. There's a reason why our Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام mentions in a hadith, this is wahi, this is revelation. He mentions that and the person is upon the deen of their close friend. Your close friend is going to affect you, whether you like it or not. This is why you see any close friends, they use the same phrases. They act the same way. They find the same things interesting. And they speak in the same manner. There are a lot of things that they share. So you cannot be around someone all this time, for all these hours, and not be affected by them. قال الراغب الأصفهاني. الراغب الأصفهاني said, ليس إعداء الجليس لجليسه بمقاله وفعاله فقط بل بالنظر إليه. الراغب الأصفهاني, he mentioned that the effect that a friend has on their friend is not only by their speech and their actions, but even it is by looking at them. And even by you just looking at your friend, this affects you. It affects the person. By you looking at how your friend carries themselves, this affects the person. So this shows you that and how يعني friendship and those people that you are around, how it's very important. And it's something which is يعني imperative, something that the person should look into when a person is trying to better themselves, when a person is seeking knowledge. You should look at those who you are befriending. وإنما يختار للصحبة من يعاشر للفضيلة لا للمنفعة ولا للذة. And it is chosen للصحبة for friendship من يعاشر للفضيلة, only those who befriend because of virtue. يعني when you're choosing a friend, you should choose that friend on the basis of virtue. How virtuous is this person? لا للمنفعة. You should not pick a friend just because that friend benefits you in a way. يعني friends upon benefits. When that benefit stops, خلاص, that's not your friend anymore. So when you're picking a companion, someone that you want to seek knowledge with, and you look for someone who wants friendship that has value, someone who wants friendship that is virtuous. So لا للمنفعة, not يعني friendship of that which benefits at the time only. ولا للذة, and not friendship of pleasure. فإن عقد المعاشرة يبرم على هذه المطالبة على هذه المطالب الثلاثة. Verily the knot of معاشرة, the knot of mixing and befriending someone is tied upon one of these three. يعني he is resembling friendship to be like a knot, and that knot is tied with or is tied upon one of these three things. يعني friendship is always one of these three. يعني friendship which is based on virtue, friendship which is based on benefit, and friendship which is based on لذة, pleasure. When we say benefit, I mean يعني you're friends with this person because maybe they benefit you just at this time. There's a particular thing that you benefit from this person, and you're friends with them because of that. Let's say, for example, someone has wealth, and every time you know, times become a bit tough, they throw you some money, a few bucks. So you're friends with them because of that money. You benefit from them that, or you're friends with them because of they let you use the car. So there's that friendship is connected to that benefit. If that benefit stops, the friendship goes away. That's what we mean when we say friendship that is based on benefit. So friendship that is based on virtue, friendship that is based on benefit, and friendship that is based on pleasure. Like for example, you have a friend, all you do is, when you're together, is you waste time. You watch movies, or you guys play games, or you guys sit down and talk for hours and hours about politics or about sports. What is that friendship? That friendship is based on pleasure. ذكره شيخ شيوخنا محمد الخضر ابن حسين في رسائل الإصلاح. The Shaykh of our Mashaykh mentioned these three. يعني the Shaykh of our Mashaykh, the author is saying the Shaykh of our Mashaykh, Muhammad al-Khadr ibn Hussein. He was the Shaykh of Azhar in his time. So he mentioned these three types of friendship in his book, Rasail al-Islah. فانتخب صديق الفضيلة زميلا فإنك تعرف به. And you should pick صديق الفضيلة. Now the Shaykh is telling you, choose and pick the friend of virtue. Pick him as a friend. فإنك تعرف به. You will be known by that person. وقال ابن مانع رحمه الله في إرشاد الطلاب وهو يوصي طالب العلم. And ابن مانع رحمه الله تعالى, he mentioned in إرشاد الطلاب, in his book إرشاد الطلاب, وهو يوصي طالب العلم, whilst he was advising the student of knowledge, وَيَحْذَرُ كُلَّ الْحَذَرِ. So the student of knowledge, you know, is beware and stays away from كُلَّ الْحَذَرِ, يعني as much as they can, مِنْ مُخَالَطَةِ السُّفَهَاء. السُّفَهَاء, They stay away from mixing with those who are dim-witted. وَأَهْلِ الْمُجُونَ And those who are shameless, they do everything. وَالْوَقَاحَ Those who are rude. وَسَيِّئِ السُّمْعَ Those who have bad reputation. وَالْأَغْبِيَاء الأغبياء يعني those who are يعني unintelligent والبلداء and those who are thick-headed so you stay away from these types of people to attain knowledge a lot of the time someone is deprived of knowledge because of their friend And this happens so much. There are so many stories. If you go and you sit down with the students of knowledge and you ask them, were you ever deprived or have you come across a situation where a group of students of knowledge were deprived of knowledge because of يعني someone who was bad-mannered or someone who, you know, and was not intelligent. They'll tell you yes, and they'll tell you stories. So for example, the author of this book, there's a story of the author of this book, Sheikh Saleh ibn Abdullah ibn Muhammad ibn al-Usaymi. He was in a sitting, he was teaching. And his durus, they are filled with people. And there's hundreds of people that come to his durus. And in his dars, a phone rang. And he ignored it. And then a second time, A phone rang. I do not know whether it was the same person or someone different. And he ignored it the second time. The third, a phone rang a third time. And he mentioned to the students to yani switch off the phones and it is not from the adab of ilm. And he mentioned it in a very, very calm manner, and nice manner. And then a phone rang a fourth time. And he mentioned it again, but in a harsh manner. And then the phone rang a fifth time. And he took his shoes and he walked out of the dars. And that dars, that day was cancelled because of that. So do you see how now that student or those students, they deprive others of knowledge because of their bad manners. Because of their bad manners. And same goes to those who are a bit thick-headed, those people who do not understand, they don't have a good understanding, they cannot understand knowledge. And a lot of the time when a sheikh sees a student and is not very intelligent and cannot understand knowledge, yani what they do is they give them the basic masail and they do not go into, you know, masail that are bigger until they are able to digest that which is given to them from the smaller masail and understand it. So if you are a strong student of knowledge and you are trying to attain a lot from the sheikh, but you're with a brother or a sister that is very basic when it comes to seeking knowledge, or someone that does not understand, someone who is very, we're talking about someone who yani does not have an understanding. Does not have the ability to understand these masail. What can this result in? This can result in you becoming deprived of knowledge. Now, so he says that the student stays away from كل الحذر as much as they can من مخالطة السفهاء from mixing with those who are dim-witted وأهل المجون those who are shameless والوقاحة and rude وسيئي السمعة those who have bad reputation والأغبياء those who are unintelligent والبلداء those who are thick-headed فإن مخالطتهم سبب الحرمان وشقاوة الإنسان by mixing with those people يعني it is a reason of deprivation of knowledge. وشقاوة الإنسان and the wretchedness of the person. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to allow us to practice what we preach. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from those who glorify knowledge. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to open the doors of understanding and ilm for us. We'll stop here today, insha'Allah ta'ala. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك.